This is Chris Ockley here at the 2011 Drake Relays with Bethany Buell, sophomore at South Dakota from Rockwood Summit. And I assume you lived in Fenton?
Yes.
Okay. Yep. And vaulter for, what are you all, the Coyotes, is that right?
Coyotes.
Okay, Coyotes. You said this was your first Drake Relays. Tell me about today, how things went, and just the atmosphere here and the experience so far.
The atmosphere is definitely great. It's one of the biggest track events definitely I've ever been to. We had the parachuters come down. That was
yeah, that was neat. Yeah,
definitely a cool thing. Kind of right in the middle of our vaulting, but it was still neat to watch. Today was exciting for me. Still working on some stuff. Had some crazy jumps. Missed the box a few times, but it's an experience. You know, you always learn from it. And jumping in Lincoln in 2 days, so hoping.
Iowa freshman Aaron Jones in lane one.
And you were state champion your senior year. I think set the class four record. 12-3, 12-4, 12-6.
No, 2 or 3.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
Well, tell me about your decision to head to South Dakota. What was?
Well, it was definitely a small squad looking at, but it just had a really homey feel, and the coaches are great.
Derek Miles is your coach? Oh, that's awesome. Yeah. Is he a graduate or did he go to South Dakota State?
Or? He went to University of South Dakota.
Okay.
Tamika Robinson,
he's been jumping there for a long time now.
Yeah, yeah.
Still training there.
Right. One of the top vaulters in the world right now. So,
I think he's ranked fourth in the world right now.
Okay. You know, you've obviously had a great success in high school, and this year had a great indoor season. Did you win conference? Were you conference champion?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, 13-6, I think.
And then was it Iowa State, or where did you go? 13-7, 13-9?
Yeah, Iowa State, 13-7 and a quarter.
Yeah.
So
okay.
Fun meet. Definitely unexpected, so.
Right. And I think South Dakota's transitioning to Division II. You said this year to Division I from Division II. Said you're eligible for outdoor nationals this year, but indoors you weren't. And I kept looking for you on the performance list, and they wouldn't.
I was in like the no man's land.
Right.
So I wasn't D2 at the time.
Right. So, but I think that Mark would have put you in the top 20 or 30 or so.
Yeah, about top 20.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Well, what are your goals for outdoor season? What's?
I'm hoping to get some shots in the upper 13s. You know, 13-9 or 10 is really what I'm wanting. And it's been a few meets coming where it's close. You know, something always happens.
Right.
There, so I'm hoping in the next
weeks,
get up there and get some shots at 14. It would be awesome.
Right. So, are you focusing just on the vault? I mean, in high school you did hurdles too, didn't you?
Yep. I did some other things in high school, but just now focusing on the pole vault. So.
Yeah. What are the winters like in South Dakota?
The winters are cold.
Yeah.
The wind makes it freezing.
Yeah.
More than you think it could be. But
right.
But it's doable. It makes you definitely appreciate the nice weather.
Yeah, which we're having today. It's a little windy, but
it's perfect. That's the other perfect condition. So we're doing a great day to jump high. But.
Right. Well, what's coming up next for you on the schedule?
Sunday at the Lincoln meet, and then we have just a local Howard Woods, Sioux Falls, South Dakota.
Okay.
The next, and then conference is that next weekend. So as long as you qualify, then it goes regionals, nationals. So.
Okay, and you guys are in the Summit League?
Yes.
Which do you know?
No, next year we'll be in the Summit
next
League.
Next year.
We're the Great West. So
okay.
It's a little confusing. Great West right now.
I think the indoors, being the Great West Conference, I believe you guys had an indoor conference in New York, is that right?
Right, yeah, that was a fun trip.
So, but it's just funny how big the Great West Conference is. You see, look at the teams.
It's
and
all
just,
over. It's Seattle to New York.
Yeah. That's wild. So, well, what's the Lincoln to meet? Is that Nebraska?
Nebraska.
Tomorrow?
Sunday.
Sunday. Okay. Yeah. Is that all events or is that just vaults? Or?
I assume it's all events.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And a clean start here in Heat 1 this time around.
Well, any suggestions for any young vaulters out there? Anything that you've, any lessons you've learned or picked up that you'd suggest for kids, you know, just to get started early or, you know, if they have any, you know, try a little gymnastics. I know some, you know.
Gymnastics does help.
Yeah.
I was a gymnast for like 9 years. I definitely attribute some of my success to that. But just make sure to, like, you can learn something from every meet, every practice.
Yeah.
Never a day that you walk away and say, well, I didn't learn anything from that.
Right.
That's what I've been thinking about.
Well, with the Division I going to the instead of the regional format, kind of the first round where they've got an East and a West now, do you know, have any thoughts or what it'll take to be in that top 48 to make it to the one of the first round?
It's about 12-9 to get you in the top 48 for the Western region.
Okay.
And then from that, you know, they take the top 12 to nationals, and that's, you know, what's hard about that is like that is the one meet. You know, you only have that one meet to get
right.
in the top 12. So it really just kind of depends on like how you play, the conditions, and the other halters, and it's kind of like a mind game a little bit.
Right, right.
But definitely take you know, up for
Northern Illinois. Yeah. Well, congratulations on your success so far, and hope you stay healthy and have hopefully see some good results from the rest of the season.
Oh,
yep.
Thank you.